This drives home an important point. You need to be aware of branch divergence. It's one of the fundamental things about GPU architectures or any massively parallel architecture that uses a SIMD approach. But don't freak out just because your code has an if statement or a for loop. Reason it out, profile the code, figure out whether this is a real problem worth optimizing. There's no real recipe for reducing branch divergence. What to do depends on the algorithm, and sometimes the right answer is an entirely new algorithm. There are a couple of general principles, though. Try to avoid branchy code. If you have a lot of if or switch statements in your code, consider whether or not adjacent threads are likely to take different branches, and if so, try to restructure. The second general principle is to beware large imbalance in thread workloads. Sometimes one thread can take much, much longer than the average thread to complete a task, and when this happens, the long-running thread can hold up the rest of the warp or even the rest of the thread block. We saw this in the example earlier where some threads performed a loop much more often than other threads in the same warp. So look carefully at loops and recursive calls to decide if this kind of work imbalance might be hurting you. In the next unit, you'll see another example, breadth-first search in a graph, where each thread is assigned a work item of random size. And if one thread gets unlucky and picks up a work item that takes 1,000 times longer than the rest of the threads, you're wasting a lot of computational horsepower as all the rest of those threads sit idle waiting for that one long-running thread to finish. So there's a lot of simple strategies that can mitigate this imbalance. You can restructure your code entirely, or you might, for example, coarsely sort the work items before size. And John will dive deeper into parallel strategies for breadth-first search and a lot of other interesting problems in the next unit.